welcome you all to Since Independence. So let's begin with today's top bulletin. Digvijay Singh said, "We lost Rajiv Gandhi and Indira Gandhi, but never compromise on terror." While discussing Unlawful Activity Prevention Amendment Bill 2019, Congress Digvijay Singh said, "We lost Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi and Bennett Singh, but we never compromise on terrorism." He accused BJP of compromising on terror and mentioned the release of Masood Azhar. Chandrayaan 2 successfully enters second last orbit, confirms ISRO. Indian Space Research Organization on Friday update on India's second moon mission, saying that the Chandrayaan 2 spacecraft has successfully entered the fourth of the fifth planned orbit, the last Earthbound maneuver in plan on August 6. India drops to seventh largest economy in 2018. India's economy has been pushed to 7th spot in GDP ranking in 2018, with UK and France overtaking the country, the latest world record data showed. UP man bets wife in gambling, friends gangrape her after losing. A man addicted to gambling and alcohol bet his wife after running out of money and allowed two of his friends to gangrape her after losing his stack. A district court ordered the police to register a case of gangrape. After that, police initially refused to take action on victim's complaint. Jammu Kashmir governor to seek centers not to open Kargil war zones for tourism. Jammu and Kashmir State Administrative Council headed by Governor Satyapal Malik has decided to seek centers permission to open Kargil war zones like Tiger Hill for the general public as a tourist destination. Lok Sabha passes bill to remove Congress President as Jallianwala Bagh Trustee. The Jallianwala Bagh Nation Memorial Amendment Bill 2019 seeks to remove the Congress President as a trustee of Jallianwala Bagh Trust was passed by Lok Sabha on Friday. "Thank you for blessing," said PM Modi as BJP wins Tripura Panchayat Polls. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday thanked the people of Tripura after BJP won most of the seats in three-tier panchayat election held on July 27. Indian Army launches e-cars for its official in Delhi. Ministry of Defence on Thursday said it has launched 10 e-cars for its official based in Delhi to help fight pollution in the city. MOD's press release stated that the first batch of e-cars is a pilot project and will be expanded in the future. That's all from today's top stories. Subscribe and press the bell icon for latest updates. Stay in touch with us to stay in touch with the world, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram.